made him quite fair. He buried all his booty in a far distant land, locked safely in a treasure chest beneath the silky sand. But then the captain vanished. I don't know where or when. His treasure lost forever and never seen again. Well, that is.
Thank you.
What a landlady! Soft, kind, and gentle.
Cut out, you ugly, you lost your both your timbers.
Who's trying to board my pirate ship?
Look, it's a really little land lover.
Don't be so cheeky, Jack. What have I told you to about playing pirates? I won't have it. I want my fingers to the bone in this cabin. And what do I get for it?
Only fingers.
Don't be so silly, Liza.
And as for you, Fiddlesticks, there's a rat in the kitchen. So what are you going to do?
We'll go and scat cat and catch that rat.
We were only playing, Mum. It's fun being pirates and seeing friends are so exciting.
The sea? Exciting? It's dark, deadly and dangerous, that's what it is. Have you both forgotten what happened to your poor, poor father? My dear Sammy lost the sea all those years ago, never to return, leaving me to look after you two, all alone.
Plunder and pillage.
We still are forgotten. and a tender. We search every iron from here to Timmy. Only how do you trade them out?
But Mom, what about trade them out?
Sister, no friend with pirates. If they get so much as a whiff of treasure, they'll tear this place apart. We should get rid of it.
You can't do that, Mum. Just think of it, a real treasure chest. A real treasure chest of silver and gold.
Rubies and diamonds.
Sapphire and emerald.
Pieces of egg.
What did the parrot say?
Oh, so I need food, Lord, and I need Peter's fruit. For the last time. There's no Peter, no kite, and no beans. Now pop it, you lot. I need my food. Say it, Vatican.
I need my
shut your big cheeky little bird. Come on, lad. Let's leave these good folk in peace. We shall return another time, and sooner than you think. Farewell, my little treasure.
Did you hear what he called you? My little treasure? Do you think they heard?
Well, just be safe. I'll put it safely in the safe for safekeeping.
Do you think it's true? Do you really think there's a far island with treasure waiting to be discovered?
And I'm sure all your dreams can come true. Your father always said so.
There's the smell of sea in the air, and something else I very important, and I believe you are expecting me.
Indeed, sir. I am to captain your first official voyage, and may I be the first to congratulate you on becoming admiral, sir.
Oh, thank you. You are a sweetie. Well, it was Mummy's idea, actually. She thought I needed a job, so I chose to be admiral. Sounds great fun, doesn't it? And I look so good.
Just your name, and already you're an admiral. It must be because you're an astounding sailor, sir, an extraordinary leader of men, an inspiration to all who serve under you.
No, I think it's because Daddy's the commander in chief. Well, let's not hang about it. Where's my thingy?
Your what?
My thingy, you know, the what's it?
The big thing.
The big thing made out of wood. Goes up and down with it.
Your ship?
Yes, that's it. Of course, we'll get used to all these new technical terms.
The ship is Crunchy Frog, sir. It's a sail in the hour.
Perhaps you can help us get cooking?
Yes. After all, we're all together out on the open.
The open.
See, that's it. I really must make a note of that.
That's right, crew. Fool in!
Crew of the Crunchy Frog, attention! Introduce yourself to the admiral.
Babum.
Not big.
Clem.
What a fine bunch of sailors, Captain Cod.
But I think this one needs a set.
He's got peril in his face.
That's not good enough, is it, Mr. Pratt?
Certainly not, Mr. Wally. Those ships need these docks that are full public safety check.
Oh, Robo.
Come on then. This way to Crunchy Frog.
It's not a wide limo, it's a live limo. And that's how Molly knows herself. She's the expert.
Not anymore, Scuttle. And Molly the limo was the best place when we pinched our barrel of sheep.
You can't say that again. She had a place to talk to crap, didn't she?
And it's a good job Molly's brother Lever didn't catch us.
Molly the limo hasn't got a brother, has
she? She has. She was calling him when we pinched her cockles. She kept shouting, "Leave him alone, leave him alone."
You got away with it, and thankfully you just sat there in the barrack and you were looking up.
You know your problem? You were all cockle and no muscle.
You're talking about an idle jellyfish.
What do you mean? I spent hours scraping these cockles off that boy's bottom.
Yes, no one spent hours scraping off your bottom. Get out of there. And look at those muscles. How are we supposed to sew them?
They're tiny. Well, that's easily sorted. Exercise makes your muscles grow.
That's it, I'm happy with the shelter. It just means fine work.
But I hate work. I hate it, I hate it, I hate it. And you know what free hates are?
No.
Free hates are 24.
Please,
the
wind, my time to
ring out the bell boy.
afraid we're heading to Judy West to search the treasure map and disappear map.
Very kind of you to let us borrow it.
Treasure, it's all you pirates think of. I knew that the map would trouble. Why don't you just give up this pirating lot and come respectful, like what I am?
Never. I'm addicted to pirating. Ever since the day that crocodile bit off my hand.
He's been hooked ever since. I see. And tell me, how did you lose your eye?
Ah, that'd be tragic, Ken, indeed. You see, seagull poop in it. You can't lose an eye because of seagull poop. You can if you wipe it with the wrong hand. Very tragic indeed. Now get me off this ship.
The thing is, my crew do it many things. Pillaging, fighting the same hard, very badly. They can't cook also or clean. In short, we could use a wench such as yourself to keep the ship ship-shaped during our voyage. Then we'll take straight back to London once we've found the treasure. Is it a deal to my boys get to throw overboard? Let me think about it.
Squawk, my fairy friend. Isn't she a handsome woman?
Is your own husband alive?
I have a notion to make one pirate wife once we get to same treasure.
So, my dear, what do you ask? Very well. One to Bury, then straight back to London.
Pirates promise.
Good. My deck and lies will be wondering where I am. And look at me. I'm not even dressed for a sea voyage. No makeup, no plush crop. I should sit in something more long-flowing, like tents.
Nonsense. You're a fine figure of a woman. Why, a good eye shadow would bring out your eyes and a good blush would bring out your cheeks.
And a good sneeze would bring out your teeth. And tell me, what powder would suit my face?
Gunpowder.
Heaven could it be insulted?
Really, where do you usually go?
Captain, the crew are unsettled. There have been rumblings down below.
It must be all that curry and beans.
No, they say this voyage is cursed. Captain, you must know it is bad luck to sail with the woman aboard. We'll all be doomed.
Forward and aft.
She will make a fine addition to the crew. Now, get the lads out here!
All perhaps on deck! All perhaps on deck! Lovely scurvy dog!
Mrs. Periwinkle here has highly agreed to be our on-board housekeeper.
But she's a woman!
That's a good point, Anthony.
Thanks, sir. I know the other thing, too. We don't want no wench aboard, Captain.
We'll be doomed.
We'll be cursed.
Doomed and cursed.
Cursed and doomed.
Silence, you maker! Any more, then I'll clap you in iron!
Oh, she's quite good at this!
Now, while on board, there'll be one of two rules. Firstly, you change your pants and socks every night. Secondly, you start eating healthy food and all this current mean nonsense. And thirdly, you go to bed at 8 o'clock. Every night.
But I can't tell the time.
Didn't you go to school, stupid?
Yes, and came back stupid.
Oh, had enough. Straight to hammock. 1990.
Pajama.
Excellent. Soon a hammock set up to keep and tie through with the help of your map of both of them. Booty to booty. You'll be lucky. I've seen that treasure map, and there's nothing but a lot of strange markings on it. You don't know where the island is. Well, that's right, Dora. You see, these markers were obviously written by a pirate in pirate code. Directions to the island that only a pirate would understand. And it even gives the name of the island, doesn't it, Paul?
That's right, Lumbago. Here's the fella.
Lumbago, so it's not just a legend. And I'm going there. Oh, if only Jack and Lies were here, we could explore it together. I do hope they're right back in London. I do miss them.
Look, Jack, the ship can start. Let's make a wish.
Oh, I'm sorry. I won't bring it up again.
No, but I think I will.
Pick him up!
Now, Pooh, the
raise their flag. It's a naval ship.
So we've blown them out of the water, Captain?
Not so far. They might have some decent guns on board. Let's just scare them with the skull and crossbones.
They've raised the flag too.
Oh, how exciting.
What is it? It looks like a big smiley face. Oh, goody, it would be Ben's. Now I can use those secret flags I made earlier on. Raise my special message of greeting.
Are they quaking in their boots? Are they swearing, Captain?
They say, can we use chaps? Fancy bottle note for a cup of tea and a bourbon biscuit? Louis, raise the reply.
I think they're replying. What do they say?
Knickers.
Dangerous. Exciting.
Ah!
And most
Four buildings.